Welcome to the T500 series infrared camera tutorial from ITC. This orientation will provide you with an overview of how to operate this line of thermal imagers from FLIR Systems. Of course, knowing how to use this camera is just the first step. Thermographers must also understand how to interpret what they're seeing, and that includes how to accurately measure temperatures. For that to happen, however, proper certification training is required. So to get the most out of your investment in this technology, ITC can help. Head to infradtraining.com/schedule, where you'll find a number of IR training dates available at convenient locations across the US and Canada. And for our fellow thermographers based in Europe, the Middle East, or Africa, irtraining.eu has the latest schedule for classes in your region. And if you're ready to get certified, stay tuned until the end of this video for more information, including a special offer for certification training. It's important to know that this tutorial applies to all the infrared cameras in this series of thermal imager. And while they may look similar, there are some differences in the technical specifications for each one that you should know more about. These can be found on the FLIR support website at support.flir.com. Once on the site, go to Help and Support. From here, select Downloads. Click on Data Sheets to display a table with all of FLIR's thermography products. Selecting the model will bring you to the list of the various camera configurations. Pick the one for your imager and click on the corresponding data sheet to view the camera specifications. Now, before we go any further, let's first see what comes in the camera case, as well as learn more about the FLIR support website and the many resources that it offers. For that, here's ITC's Jason Gagnon.
Included with the camera are all the essential components and accessories required to get you up and running with your new thermal imager as quickly as possible. This segment will orient you with the basics of unpacking your camera, including an overview of battery charging, where to find some important accessories, and how to register your camera online. Now, one of the first things you'll want to do is to charge your new batteries. We recommend charging them for about 3 hours before first use. Now, this is a typical T530, T540 case. These cameras come with two batteries, battery chargers here. Power supply for the charger can be found in the accessories box. So why don't we go ahead and plug that in? And then we can install the batteries. Now you'll notice that these lights in the front will blink while the batteries are charging, and they'll go solid once it's fully charged. So this battery here is fully charged and ready to go. While the batteries are charging, let's take a look at what other accessories are included with the camera. Inside the accessories box, you'll find some camera documentation, USB-C cable, an HDMI adapter, and an SD card for storing images. Now included with the documentation is a quick start guide, calibration certificate with the camera serial number, and a license card for your FLIR Tools Plus software. It's always a good idea to register your camera as soon as possible. Registration will extend the warranty of the thermal imager and allows you to submit a service request online. Registration can be done at our FLIR Support Center website. To access the page, just type support.flir.com into your browser and hit enter. Now, if you already have an account, you can click log in. Otherwise, click sign up to create a new account. I already have an account, so I'll log in. Now, to register your new camera, you can just click FLIR product registration, type the serial number here, and click validate. Now, the serial number can be found on the calibration certificate that comes with your camera, and it's also printed inside the battery compartment on your camera. The support center is also where you can download the FLIR Tools software, which is used for analyzing images and creating inspection reports. This program and other downloads can be found by clicking the Help and Support menu and then Downloads. In the Downloads section, click Software, and then for the category, choose Temperature Analysis Software. Then choose FLIR Tools and Tools Plus, and then choose FLIR Tools version 6. click on this blue link and scroll down, you can find the download options. Now, many of these cameras include a free upgrade to the FLIR Tools Plus software. The license is included in the camera case on this scratch card. So when you run FLIR Tools the first time, you can click the Tools Plus option and enter the license key shown here to upgrade. If you ever have any support questions, you can click Help and Support and then ask a question. You can fill in this form and then click Continue to submit the incident to one of our support specialists who will be able to follow up with you as soon as possible. All image and video files are stored on a removable SD card that comes with the thermal imager. The slot for the SD card is located under this rubber cover on the bottom of the camera. Now, it's important to note that these cameras don't have any internal memory. So it's important to install the SD card right away since you need that to store any image or video data. A good tip is always check to ensure that you have the card inserted prior to an inspection. Also, underneath this rubber flap here, you'll find a USB-C port. This is used for powering the camera, streaming video via HDMI, and connecting the camera to the PC for downloading images and streaming video to our PC software, such as FLIR Tools and Researcher. Once the batteries are charged, go ahead and install one and power up the camera. Now, during the initial startup, you'll be prompted to configure the local parameters for language, time and date, units, and several other regional settings. If you've registered the camera online, you can enter the unlock code to remove the reminder message that shows. The code is sent to you by email once the camera's been registered online. Okay, now that the imager is up and running, batteries are charged, the SD card is installed, let's take a closer look at some of the important features and functions of your thermal imager.
Before we start an overview of the camera's basic functions, I wanted to point out another great resource for thermographers, and that's the ITC website at infradtraining.com. Besides our latest training schedule for the US and Canada, you'll find a number of free tutorials, including an overview of the FLIR Tools software that Jason had mentioned here a moment ago. Now, if you're new to the software program, this is one webinar you don't want to miss. Go to our on-demand tutorials and look for the basics of FLIR Tools. It's a free one-hour webcast covering all aspects of the reporting software, including an overview of analyzing images and creating reports. There are also about 24 other topics available on demand, which can be viewed at any time by going to infradtraining.com/webinars. Okay, now that we've covered what's in the case, let's talk about the basics of operation. First, I'd like to point out some of the various control buttons found on the thermal imager. Starting with the back here, you've got the navigation pad with the center push button. Pressing the center button will call up the main menu, which you can then navigate with the pad moving left and right. To the left of the navigation pad is the image archive or playback button, which is used to open and review any saved images. To the right of the navigation pad is the back button that, while in the menu system, you can back out of a selection to the main menu or go back to a live image. Now's a good time to note that both cameras are also touchscreen driven. This makes it easy to navigate the menu system and adjust the various settings. For those of you wearing gloves, a better option will be to use the navigation pad with the center push button. Having the correct date and time entered into your camera is important for proper documentation and record keeping. These values are tied to each data file when you save a thermal image and cannot be changed after saving. To set the date and time, navigate to the Settings menu. Touch the bottom of the screen to bring up the main menu and select the Settings icon using either the touchscreen or the navigation pad. Go to Device Settings and pick Language, Time, and Units. Here you can set the time zone, the time, and the date in your thermal imager. There's also an option for the date and time format, which allows you to match the time display for your particular region. It's here that you can also adjust the temperature units from Fahrenheit to Celsius and the distance values from feet to meters. And unlike the date and time, these values can be changed later in the software. The range covers an interval of temperatures that the detector is able to accurately measure without going into saturation. Depending on the model, some infrared cameras have multiple temperature ranges that can be utilized. You work within a range, and when saving an image, all of that temperature data in that particular range is captured. The 530 comes with two standard temperature ranges, and the 540 with three, with temperature capabilities upwards of 2700 degrees Fahrenheit. To set the range, navigate to the settings in the main menu. Here, select Camera Temperature Range. Pick the most appropriate range for your application and press the navigation pad button to select the range. Once entered, hitting the back button will then return you to live imaging mode. As with range, focus is another adjustment that must be made correctly before saving. You cannot change the clarity of the focus once you've captured a thermal image. There are two ways to adjust focus on this series of cameras. The first is with manual adjustment. Manually adjust the focus by turning the lens housing until the proper focus is obtained. The other way is with autofocus. Activate the autofocus by pressing the top button on the front of the camera. For the autofocus to work properly, the target should have good thermal contrast, meaning there needs to be a distinct difference between warm and cool areas on the object. With targets that are more thermally uniform, where there's not much of a temperature difference, it might be better to instead use the manual focus. There are four different view modes available with this series of cameras. You can access these by either using the navigation pad or the touchscreen capabilities. Open the main menu and select the image mode icon. Four options will appear: MSX, which stands for multispectral dynamic imaging, thermal only, picture in picture, and digital camera, which displays just the visible light feed. Now, for those of you who are new, we recommend staying in the thermal only mode for now, as this will help you better understand what's required for proper focus. You can also always change the image mode later in the software. Thermal tuning is the process of changing the size of the temperature scale in the camera, what's known as adjusting span and level in our certification classes. Adjusting this scale modifies the brightness and contrast of the thermal image. This allows you to highlight important areas of thermal detail. And by default, the camera is set to automatic adjustment mode. This will automatically set the scale based on the hottest and coldest objects in the frame. There may be times, however, when manual adjustment is required, especially if there are extraneously hot or cold objects within the field of view. To manually adjust the image, select the scale icon located at the bottom right corner of the LCD screen. This will toggle you between the automatic and manual adjustment modes. In manual mode, push the navigation pad, left or right, to select either the top or bottom number on the temperature scale. The selected number will turn blue. At this point, pushing up or down on the navigation pad will change the value of the number. Bring the numbers closer together to narrow the span and increase contrast, or push them further apart to widen the span and decrease thermal contrast. While here in manual mode, there's also a tap auto adjust option where you can automatically change the scale based off of the temperature values in whatever region you touch here on the thermal imager. When neither number is selected, pushing the navigation pad up or down changes the level of the image. This leaves the difference between the numbers fixed, but changes the overall level of the span within the range of the camera. You can also use the touchscreen features of the thermal imager to make these adjustments. Tap the number you'd like to change and then use the slider located between the numbers and move the value up or down depending on what's needed to improve your thermal tuning. This camera series also offers a number of different color palettes. Tap the bottom of the LCD screen to bring up the main menu and navigate through the color palette options. This will open the color palette menu where you can find seven different palettes that are available, plus several color alarm or isotherm settings. These include iron, rainbow, rainbow high contrast, white hot, black hot, arctic, and lava. Regardless of which color palette you select, these can always be changed later in the saved image, either in the camera or the processing software. This thermal imager also offers several kinds of temperature measurement tools. These include a center spot meter, a hot spot box, which provides the maximum temperature inside the displayed box, a cold spot temperature box with the minimum temperature value, and two user preset options. For now, let's select the center spot, which displays the apparent temperature here in the upper left-hand corner of the image. You can move the spot around the image by simply dragging it with your finger. Same with the hot and cold spot area boxes. You can also adjust the size and location of the box by dragging the corners outward or by touching the center of the box and moving it around the screen to different regions of the image. All of these tools are also available in the reporting software and can be modified in a saved image. Now, if you're using a measurement tool, you need to also adjust the temperature measurement parameters. To access these, select the measurement parameters icon from the main menu. Here you'll find the values for emissivity, reflected temperature, relative humidity, air temperature, and atmospheric distance. Now, all five of these parameters must be set correctly for accurate temperature measurements. As such, you should know what numbers to put in, and doing so requires a Level 1 IR certification training at a minimum. To save an image with this series of camera, press the Save button, located here beneath the autofocus on the front of the imager. A good tip to remember, try to remain as still as possible while doing so, as any abrupt or excessive movement during saving may blur the thermal or digital photos, as they are captured at the same time when pressing this button. Occasionally, you'll notice that the live image freezes for a moment. A clicking sound can also be heard during this brief interruption, and the word calibrating here will pop up at the top of the screen. Now, this is normal, and it's called the non-uniformity correction. Thermal energy from the surrounding environment, or that that's generated inside the camera, can affect the stability of the detector array. This can then impact the integrity of the temperature data displayed on the image, causing areas within the field of view to appear to be artificially warmer or cooler. The non-uniformity correction is a process that resets the detector so all the pixels return the same uniform data. You can force a correction by holding down the recall button here on the back of the camera. The image will pause for a moment while a shutter, which acts as a uniform target, drops in front of the array. The detectors will then automatically reset and the camera will return to live imaging mode. All right, so that covers it for this overview of the T500 series thermal imager. What's next? Well, if you haven't done so already, it's time to get certified. For those of you in the US and Canada, head to infradtraining.com/schedule to browse upcoming training dates and locations. And if you're based in Europe, the Middle East, or Africa, irtraining.eu is where you'll find a list of classes in your region. If you're thinking about attending a training class here in the United States, we also run a number of special offers throughout the year. To hear what those are and check availability, call us at the number below or email ITC at info@infradtraining.com. And also, for those programs where six or more thermographers that need certification training, an on-site course is likely your best bet. Not only will you save money by having ITC come right to your facility, we can also provide customized training that utilizes your equipment and infrastructure too. Contact us to learn more and get a quote. And if you've already registered for a certification class, well, we look forward to working with you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.